Now, on today's video, I'm going to talk about what are spider mites, what are the symptoms, what are the signs, and how to treat them. Now, if you're new at growing carnivorous plants, you may not know that they're actually susceptible to the common garden pests, such as aphids, spider mites, slugs, and on any other leaf-eating insects. Now, what are spider mites? Spider mites, as the name can tell, they're a species of mite, and they're actually very small and red color. Here I have a little example. As you can see, those tiny little red dots on the leaf, those are actually spider mites. There's one little guy moving right here. So you can see them with the naked eye, but only when they reach a substantial population. Usually you might only be able to see one or two in the whole plant, but it's only once they become a problem that you will see a clump like this. Now, spider mites are actually more related to crabs and spiders, which means that regular insecticides don't really work for them because their physiology and their body structure is completely different than that of other insects. Now, they feed on the sap of the plant, and when they do, they tend to inject some sort of toxin in there, and that causes leaf spots and a lot of different troubles on the leaves. Now, what are the symptoms of spider mites? Spider mites can cause a couple different effects on the development of Venus flytraps. One of the most common symptoms I found caused by spider mites is that new traps will not open. So as right here, I have a little example. This leaf that I am focusing on is actually a newer leaf, but it hasn't opened at all. And that's because before they open, spider mites manage to go inside the leaf. And as they feed on, it actually causes the leaf to remain closed. So it becomes like a form of shelter for them, where they can actually feed safely and they are protected by the leaf. Now, as time passes, because of the heavy feeding they're doing, the leaf will turn yellow and then it will start to become brown and essentially black. So that's one of the common symptoms of spider mites. The newer leaves will come completely closed, and instead of opening, they will just turn yellow, then brown, and eventually they will die. Here is another example of an unopened leaf. This one is a little bit more older, and you can see how it just slowly turns yellow and starts to become brown. Another symptom caused by spider mites are deformed leaves. Now, this leaf right here is actually a new leaf, but because spider mites manage their way to infest the leaves before they develop, as they feed on them, they just grow with a really deformed shape. Now, this particular shape that almost looks like a half moon, it's actually very common when you have spider mites. For some reason, I've seen plants before where they have spider mites, and they all tend to have the same shape, just like a little half moon, and where the end or where the little tip is almost brown or just burned from the feeding of the spider mites. So this is another symptom of spider mites. Now, Venus flytraps, when they're growing healthy and free of any trouble, they will grow mutated leaves now and then. But when you start to see leaves with this particular shape very often, that's a sign of trouble. That's like a real red flag. Now, here is another example of spider mites. This leaf right here, if you look at it from above, it just looks like it has a little brown or yellow edge. But if you look at it from the underside of the leaf, we can actually see some spider mites feeding on it. You can see those little red dots again. There we go. So as they fade, as I mentioned before, they can cause small leaf spots and just small, small spots with necrosis. Now, finally, what are the signs of spider mites? Essentially, you can see them with the naked eye. They look like really tiny little red dots, but if you stare at them for a couple of minutes, you can actually see them moving. And if you use a magnifying glass, you can see them better, but they're just tiny little red mites. Now, it's worth mentioning that usually in the soil, you have a lot of different microorganisms living. They're actually springtails, then they feed on dead plant material and algae, and they're actually beneficial for the soil. There are other black and small mites as well, but spider mites, they are the only ones that are just red, and the only mites that cause trouble, at least on Venus flytrap. They can actually cause trouble in Sarracenia. Now, you might be wondering how or why do you get spider mites on your plants? Spider mites are actually a very common garden pest, and they actually like low humidity and hot, dry environments. Well, I live in Arkansas, and here the summers are very hot and dry, so it is like the perfect environment for them. And I grow a lot of my Venus flytraps in my apartment, where it is just away from the outdoors and away from all the other garden plants. And still, somehow, they will come and affect my plants, even in an apartment window. So if you have them, just don't feel guilty about it. It's something very common. Now, how do you prevent spider mites? There is only two things I can think of that you can do to prevent spider mites. One is always cut dead leaves off. Dead foliage or dead plant material is always an easy way for them to hide and makes it harder for detection. So whenever you have a dead leaf or a brown leaf, just cut it off and clean it out of the pot. The other thing you could do to prevent them is that, as I mentioned, they like low humidity and dry places. So you can essentially just mist your plants at least once a day and just prevent not to mist directly to the traps because that will cause them to close, but just mist the foliage and kinda just wash them. That will give more moisture to the plant and it will kind of wash some of the spider mites away. Now, if you grow a lot of Venus flytraps in a greenhouse or you just grow a lot of these because you love them, another option to prevent them from affecting your plants is buying predatory mites. You can find those online. I think it's about $20 for 2,000 predatory mites. And essentially, it's another species of mite that will eat spider mites. But this is something that I will do only if you grow a lot of Venus flytraps. I think if you only have one or two plants growing on your window, this will be something I will not do for that. Now, how do you treat spider mites? Now, as you may know, all carnivorous plants are very susceptible to pesticide and fertilizer. But there are a couple brands of pesticide that are safe to use with them. So the easiest and the cheapest way to treat spider mites for Venus flytraps would be a product called byern 3-in-1. And I have a little example right here. Now, byern 3-in-1 is actually an insecticide, a miticide, and a fungicide. So you get three benefits in one spray. Now, byern 3-in-1 is safe to use with Venus flytraps, Sarracenia, and Nepenthes. Now, I read in a couple places that if you use that product with sundews, it will burn the leaves of the plant. Now, it is not going to kill the plant, but it will make it grow very slow for a couple weeks or almost a whole month. So, sundews are very resistant to pests, anyways, so you probably will never have to use it on them. Now, it is worth mentioning there is another product in the market that is called bioadvance 3-in-1. It looks very similar to the byern 3-in-1, but it's not made by byern. Now, I never use a bioadvance, so I don't know whether it's safe to use with carnivorous plants, and I don't know if the ingredients are the same or not. So I think it's better to be safe than sorry and just go with byern 3-in-1. Now, before you spray for spider mites, there are a couple things you need to do first. You want to clean any dead foliage and cut it off from the plants and just take it all out of the pot. This way, spider mites will not have any place for them to hide. Now, the second thing that you have to do, and this is very important to do, is cut any clothes straps. As I explained before, as they feed on them, those straps that are closed become like a shelter for them. And if you don't cut those off, there is a big chance that they will survive the application of the product you're using. So just cut them off. Cut any closed traps on any deformed traps as well. That way you have a better chance of killing them all at once. Now, keep in mind that the foliage you cut from those plants with spider mites might have spider mites on it, so you wanna either throw it to the trash or burn it, but don't put it on your other pots because you're just gonna spread the spider mites to other places. So just be cautious with it. Just throw it away, set it on fire, and just keep it away from your plants. Now, once you have caught all the dead foliage and all the closed and deformed traps from your plants, you can go ahead and spray. Now, remember, always read the directions on the bottle, follow the safety precautions they mention, and after you spray, you want to spray just once a week for about 2 or 3 weeks until you see no signs of spider mites.